2015-06-18, concerning the sports complex in Chickasha, concerned citizens voicing their complaints.
Why it's so important, from a personal perspective, sports changed my life, probably saved my life at a point, and I think it does the same for a lot of young boys and girls. Shows them the right way to get out there and compete, proper work ethic, values that actually help them later on in life whenever you're having to apply for college or go to school and things of that nature. The sports complex is one of the nicest in the state as far as the up-to-date amenities, stands, new fencing. It's a beautiful place.
I think first and foremost, you've got to take care of the kids that their parents' tax dollars help pay for this bad boy. That's first. Then get the tournaments back in here and get the revenue coming in to not only help the sports complex and the city, but also the businesses. To me, you can have all the best plans, but if you don't have somebody in that leadership role that knows what to do and how to implement it, then it really doesn't matter. It's just going to continue to go downhill.
I'll give the city powers some credit. I think they do have intentions to... They want it to do well. I mean, obviously, you don't build it and just want it to crumble. They don't have the right people in place to deliver a quality product. And as a result, there are very few tournaments out there. The softball field is not quite as bad as a lot of the baseball fields, but there are still very few softball fields. And you need consistent activity out there. But it's frustrating to voice concerns and voice complaints, and they don't seem to be met with any kind of meaningful reaction that actually impacts positive change. And in the end, that's what Bobby, that's what myself, and that's what several of these coaches, that's all we're asking.
I'm Alan Gard. I'm the city manager for the city of Chickasha. We're out here at our sports complex today, looking at it with Dennis, and we've been trying to show Dennis what some of the issues are and what some of the problems are and challenges that we face out here. Our biggest challenge this year has been Mother Nature. From the beginning, I want to say that this is a wonderful complex. It's a wonderful asset, and the citizens should be proud of it. It is built in a floodplain, and so you're going to have the kind of issues that come with a facility that's built in the floodplain when you have all the rain that we've had. We do have a very committed and dedicated staff that is out here working very hard to prepare the fields for the tournaments and the kind of events we want to have going on out here. There is a plan in place to address many of the cosmetic issues that people are concerned about, but the main thing we've been waiting for is for the fields to dry out. We do have a 10-day window here now where we aren't going to see any rain, and I think the citizens will see a lot of progress made on the fields and see the kind of things they're hoping to see. I am committed to this. Steve Chapman, our Parks and Recreation Director, is committed to this. He's been on the job as the Parks and Recreation Director since February. So he has done a lot of planning and put a lot of things in place in order to get this thing done. We do have a budget, so we know that we have funding for this, and we thank the council for that, and we thank the citizens for that. We just need their time and patience and let us execute the plan and get things done. We're going to look at some short-term things to make sure that we're meeting the needs of our community in the short term, but we also are going to look at some long-term solutions that can hopefully mitigate some of these problems that the water causes in the future. Again, we have a lot of knowledge and a lot of experience, and we have some very good people working out here. I know that you've been out here the last couple of days, and you've seen the guys out here covered in mud because they're working 10-hour days trying to make this a place that our citizens and people from out of town will love to come to. That's our plan. We just ask for some patience. We ask for some dry days, and we ask for an opportunity to execute our plan and be supportive of us.